settings and all. Like this is what to say that six height, six font, font, everything at
arrowhead type will be, and everything here you can fix that. So for this, it's already predefined ISO 25. It's already predefined thing we already have. So for the for your convenience, you can create a number of style manager here itself. Like by clicking new, you can see here it will you can put on your own name. Like I'm using this standard format for myself, and it will take this reference of ISO. So here you can change the settings of everything, like starting with this primary units. Here you can see these are the dimensions, these are the format in which you are drawing dimensions. Here whatever here you are seeing will be coming in your drawing now. So first of all, I'm changing here to same. It's up to all up to your convenience only. Here you can use up to 2 decimal or 3 decimal, whatever convenient for you. So followed by this text height. Basically for this drawing, I will be using this 100. Whatever here I am drawing this in this model space, this drawing will be in millimeters only. So this 100 is also a millimeter. And followed by this, you have to change this arrow size. I'm taking it as 50. You can change this later if you are feeling this dimension is not comfortable for your drawing. Sometimes it may be so smaller, so at that time you can change it. It depends upon your extent of drawing. So I'm clicking OK here, and you have to click it this whatever you have created, and you have to click the set current, which means it will be currently set now, and click close. Now basic things whatever we need here are all ready. So starting with whatever the drawing you are going to do, you always start with this line command only. This line command L enter will bring you this line command, and here the crosshair you have seen is representing this cursor thing. So here on clicking your mouse button right on the left clicking it will start, you can start drawing your things. And one thing I have to tell you, this here you can see there will be some icons will be showing here. Here one icon is the ortho mode, which is actually to set to draw everything for in a straight line, like within a perpendicularity you can say. So make a straight line, you just click it or press F8, it will make this line whatever you are seeing here. It will be going straight, whatever the directions I was moving my mouse, it will be going straight only. So if it is not turned on, you can see whatever this line I can be drawn in however I wish. It won't be as much straight. You always turn on this perpendicularity and this ortho mode, and followed by that, here you can see that object snap. This object snap shows you while drawing any drawings, you need to know whether what is that point refers. Like these are some of the points the AutoCAD automatically shows to you while drawing. The you need to mark whatever the thing you want in here. Like if you want end point, you can click it, and if you want any notes, you can click it. And basically whatever we need is that end point, midpoint, and center, and perpendicular, and sometimes parallel also you need. So these are the major things you have to preset it, and then further go proceed to your drawing. So I am starting with creating one template. For template, basically in our watch manual we might have gone through this drawing dimensions, sheet dimensions, right? I will here you can see these are the standard dimensions of a paper used in our drawings. Mostly our general arrangement drawings, whatever that plan we are seeing is and all is in A1 sheet only. Whatever that any approved drawings we are getting from the headquarters, everything will be coming in A1 sheet only. Whatever that drawings we are making for some location plan or something if you are showing or some charts we are making, these things and all, we will be using this A4 sheet. And mostly we will be not having this plotted thing, so we'll be always making this drawing in A4 dimension only. But whatever the general drawings you are making, you go with this dimensions, whatever the dimensions shown here. So to create a template, first we'll go with this A1 sheet itself. We'll know this dimensions like 594 cross 841. We will create a drawing which actually fits for this A1 sheet. And for that you have to first start with this rectangular thing to make a layout of that paper. So you click rectangle and you can see that first it will be asking same like limit. You will be asking your first corner point. You fix that origin as a corner point and 0,0 I'm giving here. And followed by this, it will ask you that length and width of that paper. So first you have to put, if you are moving this mouse towards this length direction, it will take this as a length. So you can see this first thing is varies. Whatever the first the blue color highlighted thing, it will vary according to the length. So this thing we have is 841 in us. As per standard dimension. So followed by this, one is 540. Here you can see, this is the actual A1 sheet. Whatever the drawing you are putting inside, it will fix to the A1 sheet. So I am moving it further into the center. Here you can see clearly. So this is that length and this is that width of the paper. So first we are going to create as a template. Template is nothing but our one general predefined thing we have, like a preset which includes this title block, name, name of the project, and our official signature field, everything, and the scale of that drawing, everything. So this template is not a standard one. It depends upon the organization. Some organization use different templates. Our standard Chennai Divisions template is, I will show you. This is for the late time gate. This is one approved drawing from division, which currently we are doing. So excluding this this part, this drawing part, everything, whatever the borders and this name field here, you can see this. This includes the template. So we are going to create this template only, and you make it as a template file, and you can use it further whenever you are creating any other new drawings. You just create the drawing and open this template and put the drawing inside the template and arrange it according to your convenience. And finally, you can make it a printout. So this template I'm going to create. So I have first drawn a rectangular box of dimensions as per the A1 sheet, and we have to make another one double line shown there. It's up to your wish. For that, I am using this offset tool. This offset tool actually what makes it, you are clicking it, you have to mention some dimensions. It will say it is of say 1 feet or 2 feet, means you on selecting it, you can make a offset line like whatever we are doing with the plan setting out time. We are making some offset point away from our center line of our building. Like that, it will offset. It will create another line as per the offset distance you have mentioned. Like I am giving offset distance of it is in millimeter. So whatever the dimension you are giving, it is actually in millimeter in paper. So I'm giving 5 mm of offset distance, and here you can see this rectangular box will be coming. With this you have to click whatever that to which you have to take an offset. You have to click it and just drag inside. If you are dragging outside, mean it will create an offset outside the main line, reference line. You can see here, and while I was moving the cursor inside, you can see that offset was creating inside. While I was moving it away from that reference line, it was creating outside of 5 mm distance. So I'm making it fix it. And this this text box size and all defined by yourself only. These drawings, in this drawing they have taken a 20 centimeter of length. In A1 sheet it will be 20 centimeter, is 200 mm length, and this height will be somewhat 10 centimeter will be in height of each row having a 1 centimeter of width. So this depends upon you only. So I'm creating one 20 centimeter line here, which is 200. You have to put in give your input in millimeters only. So here you can see a 20 centimeter line was drawn here. So followed by this, I'm creating a bit of this. You can use offset command also, like instead of drawing this, you can, I'm deleting this now. By clicking here, you can see this 20 centimeter line I have drawn here. By using offset thing and giving a offset distance of 100 mm, I can make this line. By this, you can make this title box, and I'm giving this is a 20 centimeter. We can divide this according like like they have divided it into 5 categories in column wise. You can see in which we will take some random dimensions here, and we will finish this. I'm taking as we will complete this row everything. I'm taking off the distance of 1 centimeter, which is 10 mm, and I'm making so we have done this row, and we have now you have to columns. I'm taking this line command, and first we'll take a distance of say 2 centimeters, 20. Here you can see this one paper clip. Followed by this. Now you can see this. You can click this line. You can by using this offset tool, we can make another lines. Like I'm choosing that next field. This field has say 5 centimeters, which is 50 mm. You can see I'm giving an input of 50 here, and it will automatically create a line. So similarly, from here, I will take this third, whatever that our name of the drawing. This field, I will take another one, 5 centimeters. And one more thing I have to tell you, if you are using some commands means, and you are you are out of this command means, by clicking this escape sorry, space bar, it will again bring you the last command you have selected. Like I am facing the pressing the escape bar only now, sorry, space bar only now. It will bring me the last command I have used. Here I the last command I have used is offset, so it was bringing me that offset tool. So again I was using one take not 5 centimeters. I'll go with 7 centimeters, 70 mm. And here you can see. And again, we'll take some 2 centimeters here. And here we have that for all. Now we have to remove some parts. Like these lines and all we don't need here, whatever these lines. So for that you have to use the trim command. TR double enter, you have to press it. TR gives you trim command. You have to click on enter, and you have to follow by this, you have to click on another enter. So on while making here, you can see it was trimming whatever that lines I am selecting here. It was automatically gets trimmed. So here we have that space here. And similarly, you can use the same trim command to trim some fields you want. Some. And one more thing is trim command only cuts the extended portion alone. It won't delete actually the whatever one line you have drawn. Like I'm drawing one line here in the outside of the field. And with this trim command, you cannot delete this line. But the same line I'm drawing in here. This part you can see. This is this part and all. You can. It was somewhat a portion out of this some drawing, some line. You can see this was some extension line. You can say from this point. So these things and all have a boundary line. The boundary line for this. This line, this horizontal line, this vertical line will be like a boundary one. So while using this trim command, it will trim up to this boundary. So similarly here up to this boundary, but this line, the third here, this is now one complete line. It has no extension and all. So it will, we cannot by using trim command, we cannot delete these things and all. But actually using this delete button in your delete key in your after you can delete this. So we have done the outlook. Now we have to add this title and all. So I am for this adding title, you have to click M command MTEXT, not normal text. It is actually M text. And this same text height and this height of this text was fixed by whatever the dimension you have given already in that dim style. But to change this thing, wait, I will show you here. this annotation field will be there right here. By clicking this, you can see these are the settings for your dimension thing. Like this first one is for text changing, and second one is for dimension, like line changing, and third one is for leader. We'll not go into that deeper. First, you have to click this text style, and it will show you that text, font, everything, whatever you want. Generally, in this most of the general drawings, we will be going with the simplex .sh font. Otherwise, you can go with normal whatever that font we are using. But in general, most of the drawings I was seeing is they are following this simplex .sh font. Here, this height you can display here, but whatever the height you are specifying here, it will not be changed even though you are changing in dimension style, sir. Like if I am changing it to 50 here, means that 100 whichever I have given earlier won't be taken into account. But this 50 will be constant here. So wherever you are making a text input inside your model space, it will take this into account, not that dimension style input. So here I have given 100. Here also I am giving 100 same. Apply and close. So M text, you can see here will show you this font, whatever the font you have here. You have to drag on line, and you have to type inside whatever the content you have to pull. Like I am putting Southern Railway here. Don't worry about this dimensional variance. You can change it later also. After typing this, you have to click escape button once, and it will ask you to save this text changes everything, and you have to click enter. You can see actually that dimension whatever you have given is larger. So whatever the 100 we have taken is quite larger. So on pressing this, you can change this here itself. Like I'm going with this 10, which is actually 1 centimeter. So it will, you can see here it is 1 centimeter in paper. But already we have given this text width, this box width as 1 centimeter, so we can further reduce this by double clicking on that line, and you can see by you can select everything, and here 1 centimeter I have given, but already I have made this field as 1 centimeter, so you can make it as say, sorry, 5 mm, 0.5 centimeter, and here you can see that dimension was reduced. So now to move this to see in this field, you have to click this select this thing, and what is that name, and you have to click move M command, which means move. So you can enter, and you have to drag it to that required place. But here you can see I couldn't drag it to that place, which is why, because I have turned on this ortho mode. So to make the dragging for your convenience, you have to turn it off for some minutes, and you can see I can drag it wherever I want. How I can place it here, similarly if I want to make some more data here, like whatever the drawing it has, like SSC drawing and this our officials designation and their this drawing scale, drawing number, everything. What you have to do is you just take a copy of this thing by selecting this. We don't need to create mText every time to make a text inside our drawing. You just use this already set we have done whatever the we have done here, and take a copy of it by selecting it and click CO. CO will give command will give, get you to copy, and you have to make a copy of this by clicking it, and you can drag it like moving. You can copy everything inside this. Copy here, and you can edit it our drawing name here. You can edit it construction of the something. And here you can see this this also increases, so you can reduce the size, or you can size by changing this text height text size or by changing the text height, you can use this, or else one scale command is there. With that also, you can change this dimension here. And furthermore, you have to add some fields here, our visual's name, median, waist, MAS. For this, I don't think this page will be much enough for this. I'm just thinking this. And like trim, if you are using this command trim, by clicking this shift button, and it will actually extend it, the reverse of the trim. If you have a boundary line here, it will extend the line to that boundary, up to that boundary. Here you can see it will be extending to that boundary. So I am making this is copy of it. Like this, and just paste it wherever you want, and just edit whatever you have given already. in here D and here D. This this drawing actually it is a construction of a signal and electronic internal building which involves a signal department, engineering department, and there is operating department, electrical. So all these offices are down here. And this thing is depend upon your the authority who was signing here. You can add a depend on your nature of work. So here I have done this. Similarly, you can take a copy of this and then make here. Like SSC drawing whatever. This is one way. So we have done with this. Created one template which is for an one sheet and we are saving it as a template format here. You can see here this AutoCAD icon is there. Here there will be an option called save as here, and here you can see this drawing template in this format. You can save. We already have a some predefined template which was included in this package itself, and whatever the template you are creating, you can save it in your name. Like I was saving it as title block desktop. Creating a folder. And about saving this title block, it will be saved in DWT format. Here you can see DWT, and actual our drawings are will be saving in the format of DWG. These templates things under say will be saving this DWT format. With this, you can identify whether it is a template or a drawing file. Save this. Okay. We'll see. This template file subtitle block will be here. So whenever you need, you can make this open this template, and you can insert this for whatever the drawing you have. I already have a different drawing. I will open this drawing. For opening, you can use a Control O shortcut. There's another drawing. Oh, I'm taking a copy of this and adding this. So you can see this dimensions I have used in this drawing is a different one. So now we are going to see the scale function here. How to scale it down into a drawing. We already have a template here, but this drawing, whatever I have made it is in millimeters, which is actually in a field level. It is not to scale. So we have to fit this drawing inside this our template. So what we have to do is just scale it down. First, I am selecting the entire drawing, and here you can see there is one scale option here. Or else you can use scale command. This SC will give scale command. And first, you have to click one furthermost point in a drawing. Say I am choosing this point as a furthermost. And you have to click on put this reference thing. So you have to make two reference points in which it has to be scaled on. So for making any reference, you always fix this two extreme points anywhere in this drawing, such that you can sink it down. Whatever the dimension you want, but this one problem I will show you here. I have synced it up to this level, but here you can see this dimension things and all not changing. So what you have to do is this drawing also alone it has changed, but this whatever this dimension I have used here, dimension style, it was not changing. So to before scaling it down, down anything, you first have to make it as a block such that it won't, the dimension won't be affected in any cause. Creating a block is easier. First, you have to select the same drawing, and you have to click just block. Just type block, and it will bring you this field. Here, you have to name this drawing. Like I was naming it as foundation plan. Blocks and all will be a permanent one, and you can delete it later also. And I'm picking a pick point here. The pick point is nothing but when you are inserting a block, that point will be pointless cursor by the cursor. So you can check the click this pick point. With this pick point, you can. Know where the drawing will be fixed. So I was base point, and you can see whenever I was clicking on this drawing, it was selecting everything, which means it has converted into a block. Now we select everything this drawing. And you have to scale it down. the same way as I told you earlier. Selecting. Saving. Picking reference. It's using some point here. Now scaling it down. Count what are the paper dimensions. Here you can see the dimension thing and all not changed as it was a block now. So whenever scaling down any object, you just first convert it into a block such that your dimensions won't be affected. Now we can pick this drawing inside here. This drawing is already made. I don't need to go with this layer and all. Here I have used some layer options. Yeah, but whatever this is now it is needed for to make a drawing. Layer thing possible. I will teach you at some other session. So first you have made one drawing. This normally this line commands will be helpful in making these drawings and all. Whatever the basic commands here, the circle, whatever. Generally, you have to practice it. Without this practice, using this command, we cannot come to know in which way we can make this drawing. Same drawing can be made in many ways. It depends upon practice and learning. We can make that drawing in our own style. So I have made this here. So finally, we have to make it as a PDF. For that, you have to click this Control P, whatever that option we are using for printing. The same, you have to click it, Control P and clicking, and here it will ask you, you can use this, continue to plot in a single sheet. We are printing it in a single sheet, so you can use this thing. And here this tab will be coming. Here, the dimension, the drawing dimension we are choosing is, it was drawn in an A1 sheet, so I'm clicking A1 here. But in general, it will be easier if you are making it in Microsoft Print to PDF. If you are making drawings in A4 sheet, this Microsoft Print to PDF, you have to click it. And here it will, here you can see this paper size is more, that's why I couldn't make it here. So, paper, I will show you in some other drawing how to print it in a A4 sheet. Here you have to click it in A1 format, and here you can see the what to plot. In this field you have to click this window option here. This window option brings you to this model space. Here you can see this cursor here. I am dragging out this entire part, say from here to this extreme corner of here. So now I fix this drawing in my paper, and I'm clicking this central to plot everything which fit the paper. And here you can see there will be a plot style table will be here. Here it was, we have ACAD, grayscale, monochrome, whatever. This ACAD thing is whatever the drawing is in color means you can print it in color itself. It will be converted into color format in the paper itself. If you are clicking this monochrome or grayscale or whatever this thing, it will be in black and white only. So I'm going with this ACAD. As I my drawing was in color, I was using this ACAD. Here you can see this plot in line weight, plot transparency, everything, plot options. This plot in line weight is we have some places we have to use some thick lines which has to be shown in drawing itself. In that case, I have not used any thick lines in here. All the thickness of the line in this drawing everywhere is same. So if somewhere we are making any drawing with a thick line, we can at the time this plot object line weight should be checked so that in the drawing itself you can get a thick line. I am unchecking it now, or else on checking it also it doesn't going to affect anything in my drawing. But if you are using any line weight or any variance in thickness of the line, but you are unchecking it, means everything will be, the output you are getting from the paper, you can in the lines in the paper will everything will be same. There will be no thick thick lines that will be mentioned in the drawing unless until you check it. Now I'm seeing this. So this is the first time I was using this general A1 sheet to make it a drawing. Normally in our office uses and all, I was using this A4 sheet type only, as we don't have this plotter to make a print of A1 sheet. So with this general documentation. Here you can see that preview tab will be coming here. In this tab you can see whatever that output you will be getting. Any corrections you have to make in this output, you can change. On seeing here, you can change this in your drawing, and you can take it to print out. So I find it is somewhat. So just click OK, and it will ask you to save where you have to save it, and same with my desktop. Now we can open this video. Here you can see this. I have used this this non plot line weight is on, so you can see this here you can see the thickness variance is here, as the thickness of these two drawings are vary, so it was showing like this. I haven't made in a single sheet, imported by this is how it be made. And one more thing I have to tell you, this is some shortcut. Most of the cases we are following this PDF thing only. We won't be having this PWG throughout in circulation. So we'll be getting drawings in the format of PDF only. So if you are getting any format in PDF, you don't need to have to ask for this DWG. If you couldn't get, if you can get the DWG, means well and good. But in case if you couldn't get any DWG of a drawing, means the file of a drawing, means you can use some one option here. This thing I want to, in this insert thing, you can see the PDF importer. By clicking this PDF import, it will ask the PDF drawing, whatever you have. Say you have a drawing of a bridge in a PDF format, and having the same drawing here, you have to click the drawing. And you have to open it, and it will ask you some certain things here, like this. Here only one thing is you have to make a point is this raster image here. You can see this raster image thing is nothing but we have two types of PDF we have. One is the generated PDF, like we are making anything in Word or AutoCAD or Excel, and we are converting it into a PDF, means it is a generated PDF which was not an image actually. So whatever that PDF we are scanning it with scanner, or taking a photocopy of through phone and converting it with some applications, it will be taken as an image which was converted into a PDF format. So whatever that image, we have both type of drawings also. Whatever the drawing we have, the golden drawing we have, now we are having it in the format of raster images only, I mean scanned PDF only, not a generated PDF. So while importing those kind of drawings into your AutoCAD, means at the time you have to check this raster images. Anyhow, you cannot extract any details from that raster image. It's actually just an image which cannot be detected by this AutoCAD AI, but whatever the generated PDF, here I will show you the magic. I'm just unchecking it as it is actually a generated PDF, so doesn't need this raster image to be checked. And here you can see this dimensions of that paper. Here they have used the 594,420. This is actually A2 sheet format. I'm clicking OK. Here it will ask you to make an insertion point inside. I mean, where you have to insert this PDF, it will ask you just click somewhere in this model here. And here in that rightmost corner, bottom corner, you can see it was converting into some PDF elements. It will export that PDF inside this model field. Here you can see, without making a drawing, we actually exported a drawing here, but there were some limitations also here in this drawing. It actually detects the drawing and it was making it automatically. So for this AutoCAD AI, it doesn't know what are the tools and we have used. It was converting everything into a line command line only, like. So in case if you want to check me, here you can see I have an arrow here. It was actually an arrow of a hole, but this AI will take this. It has a separate part. This arrow alone something, and this is a line. It was not taken as an entire arrow. This are some of the limitations here. But in case of emergency, if you want to make any corrections or something, means you can use this. Here also you can see some text was overlapped. You have to make this correction. This thing is for emergency purpose only, or you can use this as a easier way to make your drawing faster. That's all. With this also, I might have shown you how to the template can be extracted by deleting everything, and you can see. Like this, if you have got any drawing and you need to have a general template, means like this way also you can make it by deleting this name of user's name, everything, and you can make this template by this way also. And this is one of the easier way to, if you have any PDF and you are need to change any correction, the small correction, and but it was an emergency, you couldn't make any detailed drawing, means that case you can use this thing. That's all. This is how a drawing can be made, and the template can be made, and the drawing can be saved. This is what was planned today to take. In further, if we have any time, I will tell you how to create drawings in layers and all, and how to use this layout thing and make this drawing arranged in a paper. Like here we have. We have this whole thing, like we have elevation section and plan, but all these things are made separately in a model space. But while making it in a paper, they will use this layout window here, and they will arrange here only. But I think if possible later, I will share this. That's all. Anything you need to ask me, you can ask. And one more thing, I am not an expert in this AutoCAD field. Whatever I was using in day-to-day life, I'm sharing is maybe we are all learning. In that way only I am learning. So anything I have told you wrongly, or anything you may feel like this is some kind of not a smart way to make a drawing, means I'm sorry for that. This is how I was proceeding, and I'm sharing this thing. You can take whatever, if you don't know, means some part you can take from it, and some part you can tell me what I have to improvise in this field. Like you can use this method of making this drawing, or whatever, some easier way, like whatever you have, that's all. Any doubts you have, madam sir? Hello? Hello? Station. Hello?
Hello sir. Yes, sir? Sir, can you tell how, like, I lost my type command line is there, na? Command box.
I lost that box. This type command. How to recover that? Wait, I will. It has some shortcut. I forgot, sir. I will find it and I will tell you, sir. There is one shortcut with this control and function keys to retrieve this command option. You are asking about this command, type command.
Yes, sir.
I will see to that and I will tell you. I actually forgot that command will be there. And I will tell you, sir. I will put it in the group.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Any doubts? I think this is enough for today. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, madam, for your cooperation. So with this, I am concluding this session. Hope if any doubts you have, you just text me in WhatsApp. If you need any clarification regarding drawing or any doubt, I'm here to help you always. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. You have done a nice job. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You explained very well, sir. Thank you so much.
So from now on, you can start making this open book test on personalized matters.